Guest literally has showbiz running through his veins. Tony Sheldon is the son of entertainer Tony Lamond and the nephew of Grammy winner Helen Reddy. He has spent his career in front of the camera and on stage. Arguably, his best known role is as the transsexual Bernadette in the musical version of Priscilla Queen of the Desert. Take a look. Joins us now from our studios in New York. Tony, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Now, you have played Bernadette on the Australian stage, the West End, and also at Broadway. How did Bernadette actually come into your life?
It was a 10-day workshop in Melbourne. I was coming off doing The Producers and one of the other actors said to me, hey, they're doing a musical of Priscilla, Queen of the Desert. You could play the title role. And I said, the title role is a bus. but I thought, oh, well, you know, it's ten days out of my life and it was a free trip to Melbourne. And it was really interesting because the original script that we had nothing to do with the film. It was about making a musical out of the movie, and the guy had to get permission from the people it was based on. And at one point, Carlotta was a character in the show.
Oh, wow.
And I was playing Carlotta in this workshop, and I had a whole scene where Carlotta was in a cabaret saying, Terrence Stamp played that role that was based on me, and it should have been me. And I said to the director, so I'm playing Carlotta in this musical. That means she doesn't get to do herself a second time. Is that right?
What do you think about that, Carlotta?
That was when we threw the script away and said, no, we're not going to do this. We're going to just do a musical of the film.
Honey, you did it so good anyway. 1,000 points
to you. Oh, thank you, my darling.
Yeah, you were nominated for a Tony Award, which is an incredible honour. And you also had the same dressing room that Liza Minnelli and Shirley MacLaine had. Did you feel their sort of magical stage presence? Mm.
It was an extraordinary feeling because when I walked in, they said, oh, this is the carpet that Liza put in, so you can make any changes you want. And I went, oh, you know, no, it's fine as it is, thank you. And there was one extraordinary day when they came in. Joan Rivers had a reality show at the time and they said, oh, Joan wants to come in and do a segment in your dressing room. Just pretend that you're best friends. I went, what? And Joan Rivers, who I'd never met, came in and said, darling, and I went, Joanie. And we did this whole thing where she sat in my dressing room and I went, you know, and how's the family? And it was surreal, you know, that's what reality shows are like, you know, they just make it up as they're going along. And at one point, they turned off the camera, I thought, and I was sitting just gossiping with her and telling her stories about the Palace Theatre, and I said, you know when Lauren Bacall was here and she finished a musical called Woman of the Year and she wanted somebody of her own age to replace her and they hired Raquel Welch. And Lauren Bacall was so upset that when she left, she took all the light bulbs out of the mirror and she took all the toilet paper. And which is a true story. And they left all that in the Joan Rivers show. So I'm actually telling that story, like, quietly to Joan Rivers, and it's in the show.
Tony, I'm a bit jealous. Your portrait hangs in the famous Sardi's restaurant. Aren't you lucky?
That was an amazing honour. I couldn't believe it when they came and told me that was going to happen. Wow. I mean, never in a million years. That is such an honour. And but they keep moving it because every time somebody new gets a portrait, all the portraits get moved. So every time you go to Sardi's, you've got to run around the whole building and try and find yourself.
Oh, so cool.
So
look at me, I look like Bill Clinton.
You look like sexy Bill Clinton, Tony. Don't worry about that. He's a very handsome man. Now, you've just got the most extraordinary pedigree. Was a life on the stage... Were you literally born for the stage?
Yeah, literally. I mean, all my parents' friends were in show business. I thought everybody was in show business when I was at kindergarten. And I used to go up to the other kids and say, what show is your mummy in?
Aww.
And there was really no question. I started when I was seven on the old Graham Kennedy IMT shows in Melbourne. And then I went into Oliver when I was 10 and sort of there was no looking back after that.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? I saw you in Melbourne do Priscilla. I think it was 2007. Oh, I got a picture and everything. Oh my God, I loved it. You're coming back. You're going to reprise Bernadette yet again, a new production. Now, what is it about the musical that keeps bringing people back time and time? And then I saw it another time in Sydney. I love it.
Yeah.
I think that's the thing. I mean, everywhere, I've played it in 5 countries now, in Australia, New Zealand, Canada, London, and Broadway. And it just brings such joy to people, and people come and see it over and over again. They're just obsessed with it. And that was why I said I'd come back, because I haven't done anything since that has brought people that much happiness. There's nothing that can beat that people just look forward to coming. They start screaming from the minute the overture starts. And it's just like a party. And at the same time, it's telling a wonderful story about people finding their tribe, finding a family amongst their peers. It's about tolerance, it's about love, it's about acceptance, it's about kindness. Mm. It's about a lot of things that the world needs at the moment, particularly Australia at this particular time.
Yeah. Mm. Actually, just on that, I would love to know, Tony, if there are people who are undecided on the marriage equality debate at the moment. I mean, what would you like to say to them?
Well, I mean, it certainly affects me. It's interesting talking to other Australians who come over here to work. I was talking to an actor and he said, my wife was allowed to come automatically because she's my wife. Mm. And they'd been married for 2 years. Well, I've been with my partner for 38 years.
Wow.
And he's not allowed to come over here at all. He's got to keep coming in as a tourist if he wants to see me. Now, I have lived over here for 6 years and my partner has to scrape up a plane fare to come over for like 3 months every year. Then he's got to go back and work for the rest of the year so he can afford to come again. Whereas if we had some sort of contract, he'd be able to come over here and live with me. And I'm just surprised about this thing that, you know, it's going to infringe on people's religious freedom and freedom of speech. It's only going to affect the people who need it. The people who need that contract so for, you know, taxation purposes or for their wills or something like that. It's just putting people on an equal status so that they can share the same privileges that most people in the country already have. That's all it is.
What an outrageously sensible statement.
A very sensible statement. Now, Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, makes its long-awaited return next year. You can head to priscillathemusical.com.au for more information. Tony Sheldon, you are an absolute star. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yay. Thank you so much for having me. Can't wait to come home.
Will you come home and come on the Studio 10 panel with us, especially if we have Carlotta?
I would love to.
Oh,
yay.
You're on TV now. You have to do it.
You look fantastic, darling.
Thank you so much. So do you.